I'm Rhonda Massad from the West Island blog, and I am here with Gary Charles. He is a candidate in the upcoming federal elections for the People's Party of Canada. Gary, how are you today?
I'm very well.
Good.
Thank you.
Good. Nice to see you out. We're doing this today because we've had some vandalism for signage for the electoral candidates of the upcoming elections. Miriam Ishak, candidate for the Conservative Party for the Pierrefonds Dollard riding, and yourself have had swastikas, maps of Israel, different variations of Hitler connotations.
I've had the word Nazi inscribed on my forehead. I've had mustaches similar to what Hitler was wearing on my face and on Maxim Bernier's face as well. So
we can always expect a little bit of graffiti on candidates' posters. I myself have suffered through that. It's relatively tame, but I've had some pretty nasty stuff, but never anything racist. And
yeah,
this is a new twist.
I mean, it's something that my kids are the first ones that notice it. Dad, what's happening? What is happening? And they just couldn't understand that me, of all people, being branded a racist. You know, I'm a Semitic. I am Canadian, third generation. But to see those words, and people don't really understand, you know, what is Nazism, and to be branded as one is hurtful.
I know Miriam also, I think she made a police report, and I think the police got involved, and they have her posters as evidence, and I believe there was a witness to some of this behavior. And I'll be showing you Miriam's posters imposed on this video as we go along, and yours as well. How does it make you feel as a candidate? Do you feel encouraged? Do you feel not encouraged, but do you feel, there's an aspect of people are engaged. There's people with emotions out there. They're coming out. They're talking in their own way. It's not the right way, but it is a way.
Mm-hmm.
So we've had apathy in the past.
Yes,
and
we have.
Let's be honest. The diversity and religion has become an issue
it's
in this
election.
It's a hot
button issue, absolutely.
And how do you propose we address this?
Well, what I wanted to do from the very beginning is to dispel some of the misinformation that's about our party, our policy. And I'm trying to get to the bottom of why are we branded racist and anti-immigrants and so forth. So it's a chore to try to get the truth out. And unfortunately, the mainstream media is just not doing their job. And there's a lot of secondhand information that gets out there that just makes matters worse, actually.
So you were telling me before we went on air that some of the things that when the fighting in between parties, I find that a bit when we're accusing people and accusing, they accuse me back and forth. I find that could be an element that shows an example.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm wondering if in that case, we would have a better chance if the leaders themselves weren't throwing stones at each other.
I think they need to stand up and stop the hateful narrative. I mean, we're being accused by the leader of the NDP of being hateful, and our rhetoric is it's just full of hatred. But there's nothing to justify what he's saying. So his supporters are following what he's saying, and I'm not saying that they're the ones that are responsible for these defacing of the signs, but they're just acting, some are acting upon what he's saying.
Do you think we could be having this problem, particularly on the West Island, because of Bill 21, and it's a very sensitive issue to West Islanders?
I'm not sure. Max has come out and said that he's neutral about this, the Bill 21. The other party leaders have said that they'll see if they're going to interfere, yes or no. So I'm not sure if it's tied into Bill 21 more so than what our proposals are for immigration, for the Multiculturalism Act. We've got some very good ideas going forward, and I think people are just getting the wrong impression.
Okay, there's a lot of that in politics, let's be honest. When you go to the Parliament in Ottawa and you watch a question period, you can see the banter back and forth between the members of the party, elected party, and the opposition, and the behavior of the officials themselves. There's a lot of accusations and banter back and forth that is not altogether composed, shall we say. I'm trying to be polite, because composed is not what that is.
I mean, they're like school children.
I find.
I mean, it's if I ever get elected, I would propose a private members bill. As crazy as it sounds, but to bring back decorum to our assembly, it's just the shouting that goes on. You can't get your point across without another person yelling back at you, and the whole crowd yells, and nothing gets done.
And I might remind us all that we're dragging our children and school-age children through the parliament to show off our beautiful country and our beautiful democracy. And I was a little startled myself when I went. I went a few years back and as a reporter, and I was stunned. Mm-hmm. And I didn't even know how to report on that without being aggressive. Like, right. I found it really hard to compose myself.
It's really crazy.
So I guess that kind of a bylaw would be good. Mm-hmm. I think, is it possible that this is stemming from the top, this kind of behavior?
Yeah, I think that it comes from the speaker not enforcing the rules. And I mean, they are supposed to stand up and everyone is supposed to be quiet. And then whoever is speaking will go on to say what he has to say, he or she has to say. But rules are not being enforced in Parliament.
So what about rules now? What does a candidate do? What can you do? Are there any recourse? Is there any recourse for you?
You're talking about this particular...
Yeah, the signage this month, this week.
It's like I've had, you know, two suggestions. One is to take all the signs down, and one is to just leave them up there. So I haven't decided what I'm going to do. It's something that it pains me to see, you know, my signs defaced the way they are. But I don't want to let the vandals win. And I think that if I take down the signs, they will declare victory, and we got this guy out of the race. So...
It's a tough one, and to all the candidates out there, we wish you well, and we hope that stops imminently. And moving forward, what would you think that Gary and the other candidates should be doing with their signs? Should they take them down? Should they leave them up? Please leave a comment here for the candidates, because they'll be looking at this, and I wish you the best.
Thank you very much.
See you tomorrow night at the Meet the Candidates.
Very good.
And there's a Meet the Candidates tomorrow night, Monday night, at the Karnak Temple. We will be streaming live from the West Island blog. Also on Tuesday night, the TQSOI, Table de Quartier Sud-Ouest de Lille, will be putting on their version of a debate in Beaconsfield, so stay tuned for that. All these are listed on the West Island blog Facebook page events section. Have a good one.
Thank you very much, Rhonda. Thank you.